Hey Stampers, it's Gaynor again. Oh, excuse me, a bit of a frog in my throat there. The next one in my alphabetical order is this. It's called Strong and Beautiful, and again, it's a sentiment stamp. So I went a bit wild with this one, chose some old sets, some new sets. Using dies from this set, which is still in the main catalogue, and I've got a job to do, get these off and put them underneath, and then I should have stuck them underneath, not out on the outside. But I'm using just the top half of the die, which is here, and the framelit to cut them out. So we're using those. I am using this beautiful rose because this set reminds me, there's a beautiful flower there and it looks like a rose. So I've carried on the theme with this rose here. So I've used that one. I've already cut my two pieces out with that one because otherwise I'd be off camera most of it. So, and then the sentiment I'm using, you are like a diamond, resilient, strong and beautiful, because it represents this stamp set, absolutely gorgeous. And it comes from here. There's so many nice ones. Happy Mother's Day. You have what it takes to be unstoppable, and I couldn't be more proud. You have truly been a shining example to me. I cherish you, my true friend. I know I can always count on you, and then you're amazing, and that's a fact. Being there for you has always been there for me. That goes with that, lovely. To a woman who does it all with grace and wisdom, thank you for always being there. Great. To a woman who taught me what it means to be brave. I reckon it's not just about your mother, I don't think. I think this is for any strong woman out there. So that is our stamp set. So we're using a bit of acetate on this card as the actual card front. So I best show you and I. Look, this is my beautiful card. There's that gorgeous rose. Because I'm using acetate, my Swiffer cloth works a treat to get any little marks off. So, and a card opens like this. Oh, and I've used that little image as well. This is also from, thank you, Mr. Boyce. Okay. It's from this stamp set as well, so I'm using that as well. Thank you, sweetie. So, yeah, and then the card opens up like this for you to see the sentiment again and these wonderful flowers. But it does stand up by itself. Isn't it great? And I've used Flirty Flamingo. I think I was a little bit too close to the edge for there, but fingers crossed we can do this again. I do love these sort of cards. Oh, got to have a swig of my coffee now, Mr. Boyce has fetched it in. Oh, absolutely perfect. So, cardstock wise, you're going to need this piece of Flirty Flamingo. I've cut this in the centre and it was 8 1/4, 8 1/8. And this is by 9 9/8. 9 7/8, sorry. 9 9/8. There's no such things as 9/8. This is just 3 7/8 by 5 5/8. This is going to go on the inside. This is our piece of acetate that is the front. So this is 4 1/8 by 5 7/8. So I ask. Ooh, right. So what you're going to need to do is just grab your scoreboard, your Simply Scored. Why did I measure this? And it's cut out, friend. And it's 2 inches. Just there. So you've got a little bit of space. So I'm just going to score at 2 inches. Flip it around and score it at 2 inches again. And that's it. I always bash things under here with this. Oh, there we go. So now you're going to fold, making sure you have got it edge to edge. It's just a small score for now because we can reinforce it later. perfect. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to lay this on my Big Shot. I'm trying to stay about an eighth of an inch away from the score line. And I want to make sure I've got it even either side. Roughly about there. And then this piece, I'm just going to push it all the way down. See how it takes it to the end? But it cuts in the centre, so I know I've got that gap. So that's what I'm going to do now. And I'm going to flip it then and do it on this side as well. So I'll be two shapes of a lamb's tail, as my mother used to say. All these sayings, wow, tremendous. So I found for the perfect shim as well is a piece of fun foam. Yeah, piece of fun foam. It gives me enough pressure and it tries to cut through the card and the foam. So I know all my pieces are coming out. I did it the other day when I attached a piece to my, the actual die itself. I glued it into place and it's been working a treat ever since. So I've been using fun foam. Let me just show you the first piece. And most of my bits then stay on my fun foam. See, most of them, and they come out so easy. And you can just grab your pokey tool and take the remainders out. I remember doing a card very similar to this, but I had the closings really close together. So they met in the centre. So I thought I'd do it again, but give it its own bit of standing up room. Beautiful. So this takes seconds to get these out. And it's virtually cut through my fun foam as well. But I've only got a small piece there at the moment, so I need to get some more out. Perfect. So now, see how I've got like a 1/8 of an inch? So I can now take my bone folder and burnish that down, because that's going to be the top of our card. Our acetate is going to get glued under there, and this is going to start to become its layer. So I'm going to glue that down, and then this piece I'm going to chop off after I've taken it through the machine. In fact, I'm going to do that now, and I'm going to do it. I shouldn't really have scored there. I should have just removed it instead. So I'm going to use my guillotine because it gives me a cleaner cut. I've just got projects everywhere. I do two or three at a time, film them all, and then I can go back. So you can chop this 2 inches off. I can show you cards nice and straight. Perfect. And we're going to use that now on here. It doesn't matter about that one being all the way to the bottom, because we are going to attach it to the bottom of the acetate. So bear with me, and it doesn't need to be folded over. So I'm just going to run this through again. Where's my other piece? Oh, there it is. I've got it. So I'm going to go and do exactly the same and cut that out. Again, I'm using this tiny bit of sponge I've got left, fun foam, they call it, and just going to put it all the way against. Oops, I will be there in 2 shakes of a lamb's tail. Love that saying. And I'm going there and back. Quite stiff. Oh, I'm definitely going to have to get an electronic one. I my piece of fun foam now is well and truly battered. There we go, there's that piece. Let's peel this off. I've lost my pokey tool as well. There it is. Doesn't take long. I find this quite therapeutic actually. There we go, all the bits are removed. I can pop that back now with my gorgeous dies. That can go back up. You could use the double-sided adhesive here if you wanted to, but I think there's plenty of space for you to glue this into place. Perfect, so there's our other piece to the card. Yeah, I did this about a year or so, maybe longer than that. Oh, I can't remember what colour the card was though. I've still got it somewhere. Or did I give them out as presents, as gifts? Oh, I can't remember. So I'm going to have a swig of me coffee, girls. Perfect. So this is the bottom piece. This is going to get attached. It's the same width as my card base. So I'm going to attach that on there. And then this is going to get attached under there. So it's perfect. It would look beautiful. And then you can see right through it. So for my glue now, I'm just going to pop that to one side. I don't want to get any marks on there. I'm going to shifty that one just for a moment. I have got a Swiffer cloth, which will get any marks off. This is just window sheet. And like I say, it's been cut to size. So I'm just going to add glue. And this, I'm not adding loads. Oh, it's not clogged. Oh, no, it's coming. So I'm just dotting. Because this is just the base of your card, the bottom. I'm not putting huge amounts on because I don't want it to squidge out. But I need it to adhere down. So tiny little dots of this, and this goes off really quickly. You could do it on the back of your hand and smear it on like our gorgeous Mandy does. Or if you've got a little nozzle like this, you can do it like this. So I'm going to just attach it. I want to try and do it in one movement and just press. So I'm using my cloth, just in case any oozes out. And I've just spotted there. See, I can take it from the back now. It's not quite. And because it's on this, it gives me a little bit of a chance to wiggle it down. Isn't that beautiful? See there? If you get any glue marks, this will get it off your... Swiffer cloth is amazing for this. Just absolutely amazing. Isn't that beautiful? Oh, we are going to have those roses overlaid on there. Then this will attach up the top there perfectly. How wonderful. So again, we're going to glue this again. Again, little dots, nothing too big. And if you do, you can just drag it out and remove some. It takes a little bit of a steady hand, but it's worth it in the end. Perfect, I think that's a bit. Do need to do the side. Right, I'm going to flip this over because this is the... That's right, isn't it? Yep. And I'm just going to lay that on top. And then I can fold that over. Don't worry if the little bottom one is hanging out over a little bit. Doesn't really make that much of a difference. And the only thing is I can't get to that glue now on that side. Yeah I can. I forgot. So pushing this just so it gets a good idea down. Oh, tongue tied and twisted me. Just checking. It's right the way along that side. Not quite that side. I'm just going to skim that little bit off because I want it to lay perfectly straight. So I'm just following the edge of the acetate now. And it is just basically a fraction. There. I think that's got it beautiful now. Oh, and there we go. It's all lined up. See the marks? Just come in. Both sides and just give it a good old polish. Get it nice and clear. Is that that side? Oh, I love it. And I've got a bundle for this flirty flamingo for some reason. There's a little, I don't know if that's a scratch or... There's a little bit of a scratch on my... Oh, I'm not sure where. I'm just going to give it a good rub. Fingers crossed it'll come off. Oh, that's got it. Yay! Isn't that pretty? Oh, love it. Love it, love it. So, that's that bit. This is going to go on the inside of our card. And I want this a little bit closer to the bottom, but in the centre, more so at the top, because you have a smaller rim here, and I've just knocked my card off alignment. I best just glue it in, aren't I? Oh, it's too late now. I've got to get that sentiment perfect now. I will use my ruler. Off the gorgeous Carla. Making sure that's nice and even. And I'm just going to reinforce the score line from the back. Oh, it's beautiful. See, it's picking bits up, but you can give it a final polish before you send it. So, I've got this beautiful. Let me just pop the lid on my glue. And I'm going to ink up my stamp. Fingers crossed. Now, I'm going to take this and I need to roughly in the centre. So I think that looks good. Fingers crossed. Oh, beautiful. Look how beautiful that image is. Nice and strong. Oh, I love it. I'm going to leave it open just for a second for it to dry. I don't want any smears. So I've got my cleaning cloth at the handy. Look at that. It comes off in no problem. So while I'm giving that chance to dry a little bit, popping my sentiments away. Oh, I'm noisy, aren't I? So there's those. And now for this beautiful cluster of flowers, and I've fetched in my flirty flamingo for this. It's just beautiful. Just beautiful, and I'm just going to lay this right down here in this bottom corner, because you've still got plenty of space to stamp your gorgeous message. And again, same in this corner. Look how beautiful those clusters of flowers are. Absolutely stunning. Clean that off while that's having a bit of dry time. Yeah, and that's from that gorgeous climbing roses. Absolutely beautiful. These are so sticky. So I'm I've only just rest it down. Touch, and I mean touch, don't press. And that's not going anywhere. None of it is. So my blocks are away. I've got my punch I haven't put away from last time. Oh, bless. So here goes. Absolutely beautiful. It lays lovely and flat. I'm trying to keep my space clean so I don't get any smears. So I've run these through. And they've got double adhesive backings on. So I'm just going to peel that back slowly. Did that get all of it? No. Some more down here. Oops. Got my nails keep breaking, so I've got nothing to... Ah, there it is. There we go, I've pulled off the rest. And I added, so the rose, because you've got this rose here, I added this one this way. Just up there. Just press that down. Oh, just beautiful. And then I did the same on the other side. Breaking off in stages. There we go. And again, I want my rose facing the other rose. And you could just pat this down with your Mr. Swiffy cloth. Give it another polish up. Oh, I love it. It's absolutely beautiful. Gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. So I'm just going to grab a few rhinestones. And I'm going to pop one in the centre of that flower. And this flower. And then I'm just going to have one here this time. because I had it on the other side on the other one. Isn't that beautiful? This is like a champagne colour, and this is with silver. You could add gold, copper, anything, just even some, oh, I tell you what, the flirty flamingo and the grapefruit grove and the lovely lipstick. I think the lovely lipstick would have looked nice on there. I never thought about that. So a final polish off before sending them to your, whoever you're sending it to. And I'm sure they would really, really appreciate that. I would love to add some Winkostella, but I don't want to ruin it. I don't want to get anything anywhere, but I love it. I got a bit more of a little space on that top one than that one. So, just need to... But it still works, it still stands up, it's still absolutely... Wouldn't they make fabulous wedding invitations? Just like that with the acetate front. And then the invitation just inside. So there they go, they stand up by themselves. They are absolutely gorgeous. And I'm loving the little print coming through off the stamped image. Oh, just beautiful. You could add any sentiment to that. A birthday, anniversary, Mother's Day even. That would make a beautiful Mother's Day card. Absolutely wonderful. What do you reckon? I absolutely love them. So this is the one I did earlier. And this is the one we just made together. Oh, I love it. Absolutely love it. I'm going to try and adjust my light a bit. That's better. So there we go. There is my strong and beautiful card. Because that's the name of the stamp set. Just love it. I absolutely adore it. I love, 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 love it. So, if you liked it as well, please, I'd love a thumbs up and a share. That'd be amazing. And if you haven't subscribed and would like to see more, please press the subscribe button and the little bell straight away. I do try and post every single day, so... And I'm getting ready for... Once I get to 10,000 subscribers, I'm going to be doing a beautiful giveaway. I've got some wonderful gifts coming together. And there's going to be... We're going to have some little rules set. But, yeah, you can win some wonderful prizes that I've got on the go. So, let's hurry up and get me to 10K. Love you all so much. Bye for now.